Oh, most gracious and holy Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for each and everyone that is listening to me under the sound of my voice. Oh, God, move by your Spirit. Lord, touch the lives of each and everyone that is listening, Father. Lord, I thank you, Father, for this time, this season that we're in. It is an season for favor, and Lord, it is an open door season, Father, and is also a time to where we going to live, laugh, and love, Father. Lord, we have also have real life, show real life, have real love, and have a real great conversation. Lord, I just thank you, Father, for today. And Lord, I thank you, Father, for the vision and the future of the RH3 show. And Lord, I just thank you, Father, for the radio execs, the team members, and each and every one that is listening to me under the voice have a part of in making this radio show, this radio program, this talk show, TV show, whatever it may be, great. Lord, I lift your name on high and glory and magnify your name, because it's you that live, move, and have I been. In Jesus' name that I pray, amen. Y'all, I wasn't trying to rush that prayer, but I still had to do what I had to do to get on here to talk to you all. Give y'all a little brief update. Just talking. Look, this conversation may hold an hour or whatever. But hey, I'm here. We're going to talk about it. We got some stuff, you know, to discuss. And it's all right here, right now, and all new right here on the RH3 show. Y'all know what to do. Y'all know what time it is. Roll tape track.
And now we're pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Switch my old status, that's from sinner to saint. As winners we can't live by the picture they paint, because they know that all the inner is changed. So we must live out our lives with a sense of restraint, which means do I live or we ain't. We are controlled by the flesh, which is busy this way.
My family, my friends, my people, welcome to this show. I mean, welcome to the RH3 show. If you are a new listener, or if you are our returned guest, our returned co-host, thank you so very much for joining in on today's conversation, today's talk. We're not going to have nothing planned for today. We're just going to have a little long, brief update and a long conversation on you all, and let you all know what's been going on with me. Let y'all know what is going to be going on with me. Let y'all know what's be going on with the future of this radio show. And Lord, and y'all, it's a lot. It's a lot. And so, we're here. And so, hey, let's get started. It is time for our kitchen table talk. All right, pull up a chair. Let's have a conversation. It's time for our kitchen table talk. All right, y'all, it is time for our kitchen table talk. And this is where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on, this is where I give you all, we just have a great conversation, just to sit down, chit chat or whatever. And we just talk. And so, y'all, we're going to discuss the elephant in the room. We're going to discuss, you know, what the extended break and, you know, our continual on extended break. And so, yeah, but before I get into that, how have you all been? Let me show more respect and let y'all know the preliminaries or whatever or what have you. And Yeah. How has things been going with you all? With me, your boy Red, everything has been going well, and everything's been good. And so I thank you all for just been who you are. I thank you all for who you all continue to be, and I thank you all for who you were, who you all have been. And so you all, this as you all know, that we here on one of our one of our syndicated stations been on an extended break. And so what have we been doing? Look, when I tell you, I've been working. I have been slack with the podcast platforms, but I still been working on the channel, working on the show, and we've been doing, scheduled, videos on YouTube, and we also, our team has expanded, and you know, we just been reaching out and trying to broaden our viewership and broaden even more our put it like this, it's not what you know. It is what you know, but it's majority of the time it's not what you know, it's who you know. And you know, just getting it out there. I mean, getting, you know, plugged and you know, doing what we can do. And so that's what we've been doing, and you know, we've been working something out. So even so, y'all, on our spare time, of course, I just been resting whenever I am not doing prep work for videos. And so you can continue, you know, being that we are on break, you can continue to listen to me weekly and watch me weekly. I've been producing some great length videos on YouTube, and you know, doing some inside scoop with Red in video format, and you know, it's just been going good. It's been going very well and smoothly. Got some new followers over there, or what have you, and you know, that's been that. And I have been thinking, you all, being that, you know, I don't want to be disrespectful whenever I say it in this way, but whenever I, you know, initially found out of our return date, you know, hey, like they say, you got to turn lemons into lemonade. And so what I've been doing since I, you know, stumbled upon and heard the announcement of when we were returning, you know, at one of our stations, I'm like, okay, you know, hey, this can still work, and it's going to work. And I just started planning. Reason being is because during that time, it will be our, you know, 1 year, anniversary date. And I'm like, okay, all right, interesting. What can we do to come back? And so what can we do? No, what can we do to bring back listeners? What can we do to, you know, whatever? Because we were going on a stride. I feel that we had a little stride there. And, you know, the devil, you know, hey, the devil been busy, let me say that much. And I will say this as well, even with that, whenever the Lord initially given me the when the Lord initially given me the idea and the vision for this new season, the season 5. Do you all remember whenever Do y'all remember whenever we started promoting the fifth season of the radio show, and I said that this year, to be elevated, you have to expect the unexpected. So far in this fifth season, I've been taken off the air from stations or whatever. Not just one, but, you know, well, mainly one, and then brought back, then taken off, then brought back, then taken, not those many times, but y'all get what I'm saying. And so I'm like, okay, God, okay, you know, what have you. And even, you know, the little hiccups that we've had, you know, on my flagship station in the Bahamas or whatever. And so, you know, you got to understand, and all this is coming from a pure place and encouragement. Let me say this. Encouragement. We have to know when the enemy is busy. You know? You have to know that, for one. And know, for two, you have to know that without a fight, or without a fight being presented or present, well, let me back up and let me say this much. The devil is, the Satan, the enemy is not going to bother you when there is nothing in front of him or nothing around you, you know, for him to fight. I hope I'm saying that. He's not going to bother you when he don't see nothing that is pointing to you for growth, pointing to you for, you know, coming to you for growth, or coming to you for expansion, or coming to you to get a blessing. If he don't see that, then there's no need for him to be bothering, and there's no need for him to try to stop. But if there is something there that could elevate you, you know, or to get you to a higher place, or he gonna try to stop you. He gonna try to, you know, whatever. And I feel that that's what, you know, has been going on with, you know, the trick and the schemes of the enemy. And so we have to realize what's going on. We have to realize, okay, let's try to figure out ways to not figure out ways, let's use, let me say that, thank you Holy Ghost, thank you Holy Spirit, let's use the tools that God given us to trample over scorpions, to trample over, you know, to wild the fowls of the devil, to just defeat the enemy. And so we have to use that, and of course prayer is a prayer is a weapon, and faith is the steering wheel. No, for real though. We had to use prayer, and, you know, we had to use our heavenly language, you know, in the time of praying and interceding on, you know, whatever. We have to do that. And so once stuff come upon us that, you know, that is presented to us, that is not of our favor, pray on it, pray against it, pray, okay, Satan, devil, you a liar, you know, every time you think of it, just pray and intercede and say, okay, God, you know. And I always tell people, when you're praying for something, say that initial prayer, and don't continue to go back and ask him for it, just continue to thank God for it. So initially say, like, if I'm believing God for healing, okay, Lord, you know what's wrong with my body. You know that there's some illness here, Lord. I just thank you, Father. You know, whatever. Call myself healed in the name of Jesus. And devil, you a liar. The Lord rebukes you. And, you know, this, that, and the third. Whatever your prayer is. And then after that initial prayer, just continue to thank him and continue to say, okay, God, I thank you for my healing. I thank you that, you know, by your stripes I'm healed. You was wounded for our transgression, bruised for our iniquity, and chastisement of my peace was upon you. And by your stripes I'm healed. You know, continue to quote scriptures. But that initial, you know, prayer that you already asked him for, you know, you don't have to go back and continue to, shall we, like you say in the streets, you know, what, you know, stuff it down my throat, or stuff it down his throat or whatever. But, you know, I said all of that to say this: whenever you are presented with something that, you know, okay, this ain't nothing but the works of the enemy, just continue to pray. Just continue to pray, because, and don't waver, don't be hindered, don't, you know, do things that can cause you to lose out on your blessing, because it's a blessing on the way, and the devil's trying to stop, you know? The devil's trying to stop. Some way, somehow, the devil is trying to stop. And Lord, as we say, or as I say periodically, that I believe that you'll continue to raise up somebody somewhere to use their power, their integrity, their power, their influence, you know, to help me. And that somebody, Lord, is a child of you. Somebody is one of my brothers and sisters in Christ. Somebody that somebody, you know, has favor. And so, Lord, I just thank you, Father. I just thank you. I've given you all the honor and all the praises, you know, for that. And so that's all I have to say during the kitchen table talk. I'm going to come back and briefly give you all an Inside Scoop with Red segment, because there's a lot been going on and a lot that I have planned for you all come March. And so, yeah. So keep it. Keep it where you got it. More of the RH3 show is coming up next. Come on. Yeah. I miss you all. We're going to talk some more, and I'll give you some more updates on me and, you know, world and entertainment news. And hey, we're going to peel up out of here. I am and we're going to come back. Well, I'll say that in the end. So I'll be back in just a moment.
Here's your great moment, fact, quote, or lesson in Black History for today. Staying focused on your goal and working tirelessly towards it are two of the areas that five-time NBA Lakers champion, legend, and icon Kobe Bryant stood for. And today's great moment in Black History is highlighting 10 of Kobe's top rules for success. And they are: number one, have a champion's mentality. Two, outwork your potential. Three, learn from failures. Four, be a long-term thinker. Five, find your passion. Six, challenge yourself to grow. Seven, keep going. Eight, protect your dreams. Number nine, be driven. And 10, achieve greatness.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit the RH3Show.com.
Got to catch up on the news regarding politics, or if you want to know news about the TV, movies, sports, and or the music industry, be it if it's in gospel or any other entertainment genre, well, it is time for the Inside Scoop of the Rufus right here on the RH3 Show.
All right, you all, I am back. We are back, and it is time for our Inside Scoop with Red segment right here on the RH3 Show. And this is where I give you all an honest and unscripted opinion on world and entertainment news. And so, you all, this is just a brief Inside Scoop with Red news segment for you all. And so I just want to come on here and briefly speak for a second, and turn it over to Nina, and then we're going to, you know, roll roll up out of here. And so, because, you know, nothing is really planned, but I just want to, you know, jump on here and give you all a dose of what you all have been missing. And so let's put us in the hot seat in the beginning. The RH3 show will be returning to work or whatever, turning, you know, for our new broadcast on air on radio March the 22nd. And on that day, you all, you know, you remember back whenever early January, when I was telling you all that God has given me a vision. God has given a vision for this broadcast for the new season. And so once I found out the return date for the show, you know, and I have a very great relationship. I feel it could be a whole lot better on my end. Of course, on my end, because, you know, the Lord already have his thing together. It's just we need to get ourselves, you know, straight whenever we are out of, when we can be out of line, or when we, you know, fall short or whatever. And so I'm not saying that I have fallen short. I'm just using that as an example. But I have a great relationship, and even in my falling short, you know, I would say, you know, could be reading the word more often, praying more often, fasting more often, interceding more often. But, and again, in the conversation with the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit had told me, hey, when you return back from, you know, your hiatus or whatever, and once you return back, set it ablaze. Set it off. I'm like, okay, you know what, God? I want people to turn on the radio show and listen, turn on their radio and listen to me. I do. I really do. Honestly, I do. And so, with that being said, come the 22nd, that is going to be the week before or the week of our 1 year anniversary. And so, hey, our new and I told y'all what it was, our new announcer, prayerfully is going to be available then. And, you know, I'll introduce him. Not really introduce him, but he's going to be, you know, getting put to work on that day as well. And so I ain't going to tell y'all what's going to be announced. I'm not going to tell y'all what areas and how he's going to be used. But, you know, wherever y'all listening to me on, what city, no, what state, well, let me go back, what country, what state, what city, oh, trust me, I'm going to turn it out, you know, all in the name of the Lord, you know, we're going to just set it up, we're going to, you know, be relaunched, not really relaunched, but we're going to, you know, be real raw, straight to the point, but all from a Christian male perspective. Going to have great conversations, but all from a Christian male perspective. You know, it's still going to be the same RH3 show, but it's just going to be a no host barred, but in you know, all faith based. All, you know, because God, and I had, was convicted. And I don't know if I told y'all this or not, but I was convicted a couple weeks or so ago that God blessed me with this baby here. I shall call it a baby. And I'm not using it like I should, you know? And so, hey, great more conversations. He said, if you want to be big, you got to think big. And so, 2 weeks ago, we got a operations. Oh, excuse me. Oh, that was a midday yawn. It still it is what it is. But we got a new operations coordinator, And we still got my nephew, Jaleel. He's doing his, you know, going to be doing his thing. And so, you know, I know the offer is still open. You know, being that we all been on break, you know, get back in the swing of things and getting, you know, topical discussions for Real Talk with Red or whatever. And so all is going to be good. And I'm just excited and elated for it, you know. Excited and elated for what God has for us. And my announcer is currently on break. But, you know, I'm going to present some stuff to him this the first part of this month, so we can get everything squared away and make sure that all thing is you know, coming to fruition of what God has given me in a vision. And so that's my plan and that's my thought. Yep, we are returning back on air March the 22nd, and we're gonna come in here like a hurricane, for real. Come in here, you know, I'm ready. I'm just eager and ready to get back into the swing of things, you know. But I still need my break. I still need to, look, y'all, trust me. I've been busy, but this week, I think I'm going to take a little mini break. Like a mini, not really, I've been taking a break, but I'm just saying, on my own. Like, not leaving the town or city or whatever, but I just need sleep. I need a minute vacation, a staycation. And so, I did YouTube majority of last week. I did a few radio, you know, segments or whatever, radio episodes. And so, yeah. I can't wait till you all get the announcer. I can't wait till y'all for y'all to meet, you know, him or whatever. And he won't be on air like getting an interview done, but, you know, just see what he, you know, has to announce for us, all right? And so, yeah, that's that. Oh, and another thing, part of the Inside Scoop with Red segment, we've had... Well, before I say that, I'm going to say this. Condolences to those we've lost so far this year. Last week, we lost a great legend, the honorable, the beautiful Miss Cicely Tyson. Who else have we lost? We lost a few more celebs early this year. And, of course, we talked about Dorinda, you know, before. Matter of fact, that week before we got off. And so, spoke on her briefly. And what else? Who else? I think that's about it, you know, on, you know, whom we've lost. But, next thing, y'all, I am going to give a review of Wendy's Wendy Williams biopic. Now, my secret was we were supposed to have her on the show, and we were supposed to have Ciara Payton on the show, but your boy Red dragged his foot in continuing to securing those interviews. But prayerfully, we'll have her on in the future. Ciara in the future. Whatever. But let me take a quick break. I've been doing too much talking. I'm going to take a quick break. Nina is here. She's going to, you know, pop back in and do her gospel news. And, she's here for that, for the gospel news segment with Nina Taylor. And then I'm going to take a music break, and then I'm going to come back and give you all my review of Wendy's movie and documentary. Y'all are going to be shocked at what I'm going to be saying. All right. More of the RH3 show is, you got it, coming up next.
Hi, everybody. I'm Nina Taylor, and this is your gospel news. Tasha Cobbs Leonard, born July 7th, 1981, in Jessup, Georgia. Gospel singer, songwriter, and pastor who broke out in 2013, Grammy-winning award single, Break Every Chain. She began her career career leading worship at New Life Ministries, her family church founded by her father, Bishop Fritz Cobbs. In 2006, she accepted a job with Pastor William Murphy and spent 3 years touring the U.S. as part of the musical ministry. In 2010, she launched her own solo career, releasing the album Smile independently. In 2013, she signed with EMI Gospel and made her major label debut with the album Grace. The album topped Billboard's gospel charts and even crossed over to number 61 on the pop charts, while its lead single, Break Every Chain, became an even greater success and went on to earn a Grammy Award for Best Gospel Contemporary Christian Musical Performance. 2 years later, she moved to Motown Gospel for the album One Place Live, recorded live at Redemption Church in Greenville, South Carolina, an even bigger success. It too reached number one on the gospel charts and hit number 28 on the top 200. In early 2017, she married producer Kenneth Leonard, and months later, Tasha Cobbs Leonard released her fourth album, Heart Passion Pursuit. Sister Rosetta Tharpe is widely acclaimed among the greatest sanctified gospel singers of her generation, a flamboyant performer whose music often flirted with the blues and swing. She was also one of the most controversial talents of her day. Her pursuits leaped into the secular market. By playing nightclubs and theaters, she not only pushed spiritual music into the mainstream, but in the process also helped pioneer the rise of pop gospel. Tharpe was born on March 20th, 1915, in Cotton Plant, Arkansas. The daughter of Katie Bell Newbin, she was a prodigy, mastering the guitar by the age of six. At the same time, she attended holiness conventions alongside her mother. In time, the family relocated to Chicago, where Tharpe began honing her unique style. Blessed with a resonant vibrato, both her vocal phrasing and guitar style drew heavy inspiration from the blues, and she further aligned herself with the secular world with a sense of showmanship and glamour unique among the gospel performers of her era. Tharpe remained first and foremost a gospel artist, although her credibility and popularity were seriously damaged. Not only did her record sales drop off and her live engagements become fewer and farther between, the situation did not improve as she spent over a year touring clubs in Europe, waiting for the controversy to die down. Tharpe's comeback was slow but steady. By 1960, she had returned far enough into the audience's good graces to appear at the Apollo Theater alongside the Caravans and James Cleveland. While not a household name like before, she continued touring even though suffering a major stroke in 1970. She died in Philadelphia on October 9th, 1973. The Gospel News presents These Moments in Black History. Before Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on the bus in Montgomery, Alabama in 1955, there was a 15-year-old who chose not to sit in the back of the bus. The young girl was Claudette Colvin. Touting her constitutional rights to remain seated near the middle of the vehicle, Colvin challenged the driver and was subsequently arrested. She was the first woman to be detained for her resistance. However, her story isn't nearly as well known as Rosa Parks. Held the grandmother of the women's movement, Dorothy Height used her background in education and social work to advance women's rights. She was a leader in the Young Women's Christian Association, the YWCA, and the president of the National Council of Negro Women for more than 40 years. She was also among a few women present at the 1963 March on Washington, where Dr. King delivered his famous I Have a Dream speech. Alice Coachman, 1923 through 2014. She grew up in Albany, Georgia. The soon-to-be track star got an early start running on dirt roads and jumping over makeshift hurdles. She became the first African-American woman from any country to win the Olympic gold medal at the 1948 Summer Olympics in London. She set the record for the high jump at the Games, leaping 5 feet 6 and 1/8 inches. She won 34 national titles, 10 of which were in the high jump. She was officially inducted into the National Track and Field Hall of Fame in 1975 and the U.S. Olympic Hall of Fame in 2004. Well, that's your Black History Moments and your gospel news. I'm Nina Taylor. Let's get back to more great gospel music on this great station.
Have you ever thought about starting your own podcast? When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions. How do I record an episode? How do I get my show into all the apps that people like to listen to? And how do I make money from my podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is so very easy and simple. It is Anchor, y'all. It's Anchor. Anchor is a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it is 100% and ridiculously easy to use. Most of all, it is free. And now, y'all, Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad here. I use Anchor for my radio broadcast as another branch to advertise and promote my episodes and my show that stems right from YouTube. And what I like about Anchor is that it distributes all to many platforms, as well as it has an in-depth statistics to where you can see how your podcast is doing. That's cool, right? I love it. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, please go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters who are already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. My name is Red, and I'm the host of the RH3 show. I cannot wait to hear your podcast. You're listening to The RH3 Show. You can visit my website at therh3show.com.
I'm expecting a move of God. Anticipating a move of God. Releasing faith for a move of God in this place. Anybody else?
Anticipating the move of God.
Releasing
faith for a move of God.
In His place. Hey, get ready. I am not seen. Hey,
get ready.
Hear and not heard. All of the things God has prepared. Expecting a miracle, anticipating a miracle, releasing faith for my miracle in this place. Oh, 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 oh. Releasing my faith for everything that you have for me.
So we are back, y'all. We're back. We're back for the my portion of the Inside Scoop with Red segment. And this is where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on world and entertainment news. We're back with more of it. And I said that on this segment, we were going to be speaking and talking about a review of the Wendy Williams movie. And, this is just a whole update on, you know, me, update on what I've been doing and update on, you know, a lot. And so, this is just a gumbo pot of, you know, what's been going on. You know, that's what it is. the Wendy Williams movie. Y'all know I've been talking about this. Y'all know I've been promoting. Y'all know, you know, even those on social media, those on my podcast platforms, those on especially YouTube. And so YouTube listeners, this is it. This is it, and I'm going to break this up into just this a segment or whatever to talk about it. And so let's go ahead. Prior to the movie, I did a all access Wendy of my journey of how I became a fan of Wendy. Or whatever, and you know, just that and the third. And so the movie, it was let me say this much before I go into breaking down the details of my commentary. The movie was great. I really enjoyed the movie. I'm gonna be honest with you. Ciara Payton and Morocco Amari, they did their thing as Kevin and Wendy. They did their thing as Kevin and Wendy. And I really, when I say I enjoyed that thing, I enjoyed that movie. Was the movie far-fetched? Was the movie a lie? Was the movie the truth? Was the movie, you know, whatever? My opinion is that movie was based on what we knew and what, you know, fellow fans knew. It was all the truth. To me, it was. It was all the truth. It was basically, if you knew Wendy, it was basically what, you know, what we know. And it was lined up with, okay, this is Wendy, this is what happened. And basically, if you knew Wendy, you knew what was happening. The only few things in that movie that I really didn't know is that, of course, I knew about a fling with Eric B. You know, not really knew. It was, you know, talks or whatever. But I didn't know that she was, you know, pregnant by him, and I didn't know that she had an abortion. And so, you know, of course, y'all know my stance and, you know, whatever, but I'm not going to go into that. I'm just giving a review now. I didn't know she had an abortion. And so that was my surprise on that part. And what else was I surprised about? Her drug and coke habit. I knew she was on drugs, but my goodness, she was on it. And so, people saying, well, I'm not going to give a spoiler. whatever. It is Monday. The thing's been repeating. So you should have watched it if you was going to watch it. And so, yeah. That blew me away. And it was a few other stuff that I want to take in. I just, you know, on the flip side of it, I just see, you know, the things that Wendy been through. I mean, you know, it was this movie was she told her story her way. She told her story, you know, this was a visual, put it like this. This is a visual form of what she been talking about. It's a visual form of her book. It's a visual form of, you know, whatever. It was all put in a play. Okay, my critique. Well, let's go back to the documentary. She opened up and she was very, because you know when she cried on her show, you know, hold back and, you know, sometimes don't let it out. But the title of that documentary was Wendy Williams, What a Mess. And so this goes into the critique. So I'm going to go back to the movie and critique the movie. To me, the movie was rushed. It was rushed. It could have been, that movie could have been easily and all full and meaty of a good 3 to 4 hours. I would have, even with her controversial interviews, could have been reenacted. Only thing that was reenacted in that movie, you know, that she always talked about, of course, was her drug use. What else was reenacted? Some other scenes that I'm not going to speak on, you know, because of touchy issues. But you have to watch it, and it's all respect of, you know, you all. What else was reenacted? It is a few, the total incident was reenacted. You know, a few others, but, some more of her incidents that happened on the radio could have been reenacted. Like I told you all, you know, not those on radio, but folks who listen to me on social media and on podcast platforms and on, you know, my YouTube video know that I talk about, you know, have been talking about other, you know, whatever. The R. Kelly incident with her and Kevin and the van and, I mean, not the van and watching the tape and the limo, that could have been, you know, reenacted. Of her actions of her watching it. More interviews with her on radio, that could have been reenacted. The Whitney Houston interview, I was a little disappointed on how they shown that. That was rushed. You know, other interviews, other controversial interviews with other, you know, highlighted interviews that she had could have been reenacted on in the movie. But I felt that it was good. And but again, it was good, and it was a whole good 2 hours, and it did chronologically portrayed her, you know, of what her life has been up to now. And, you know, from an A to a E rating, I give the movie a solid B. A solid B. No B plus, no B minus, a solid B. Only because it was rushed, for one. Two, and not saying the quality was rushed. It was just rushed as in, you know, they crammed her whole 30-year plus career into 2 hours. And I understand that. I understand that. Again, this movie can be a part two. The Wendy Williams Experience could be a whole 2 hours of her radio career, just the radio career portion of her career. Well, radio and TV. The Wendy Williams Experience. And so if y'all hear that on air and y'all see it on Lifetime, of a new movie called The Wendy Williams Experience, then y'all know where it came from. Me. But anyway, I could see it. I could see it. I could easily see it. Easily see it. And it could be, you know, great as well. Just like this movie and the documentary was. Okay. That was my critique of it. And I wish, you know, I get why she didn't want to, show little Kevin. He's not Kevin Jr. because his name is Kevin. I ain't going to give him his full name. But, you know, his name is Kevin, but his dad's name is Kelvin. You know, that's his dad's birth name. But I can get it, because that's a parent thing. And, you know, Kevin did not want to, you know, he didn't ask for the limelight and whatever. So I get it. But I wish we would have saw him in the documentary, you know, about, you know, his journey with his mom and dad. Seriously, journey of being the son of Wendy Williams, because if something should happen to Wendy, just trust, he gonna be in the limelight. Trust me, I believe that. But anyway, go to the critique of the documentary. It was just the name of the title, Wendy Williams, What a Mess. That's not, you know, speaking ill and not bad of Wendy, but it was just that. It was her giving her, you know, well, we finally hearing the breakdown of what's been going on with her throughout her whole tenure of radio and TV and her whole life. And it's just, it was, you know, instead of her holding back. Oh, by the way, go back to the movie. I wish they would have, you know, and I get that they, you know, when she fell, when she passed out with the Halloween, whatever. I wish they would have gave a more in-depth reason of why she passed out, because you cannot sit up here and tell me that, she was hot on her. She could have been, because of, you know, her actions prior to putting on that suit. But I haven't been to a talk show, but I've heard numerous accounts of people saying that in studios, it is always frigid cold in studios. And so, especially Wendy's. But I'm going to leave that alone. I would have wished they would have, you know, gave more in-depth reason of that. And, you know, of her going to work with, you know, fractured limbs or hairline fractured limbs and, you know, more, because it's more to me, y'all, and this is all based on my opinion. To me, it was told, but it was still a bit watered down. Like, it's more to that. It has to be. It has to be. It has to be. Because, honestly, in the movie, of course, the verbal or whatever, but I'm going to just leave that alone. Because it made Kelvin, seem to be in the best light. It just made him seem like he was just a helpful dude. But, you know, did his thing. And you know, the anger part of what Wendy said, it didn't live up to what she'd been saying. You know, his anger part, because it was very low key. It was very minor and minute. Move on. Documentary. Again, what a mess it was. I really was uneased watching that, only because hurting for Wendy. Like, this cat brought you down, you know, to this, and you know, and I know you were hurt, and I understand all of that, and I'm saying this as a loyal follower, loyal fan of Wendy. And I always tell you, I'm not a yes man or whatever. I give, you know, my commentary or whatever. But I'm going to say this and I'll move on because we got to go. I was just blown, you know, by the emotions and, you know, how Kevin hurt her. And you know, the documentary showed more of her emotions, and of course it was supposed to be, and was real raw, rugged, candid, everything, you know. But anyway, that's my review, that's my thought on the movie and on the documentary. Y'all, it has been a great time to come back on here to just briefly give y'all an update on me and you know, not only me, but also, you know, just give y'all a little tease of my commentary on what has been going on. Much prayer to those family who we've lost. I mean, to the people that we've lost since the beginning of the year. It has been a lot. I just, you know, can't really, you know, really fully name them, but you know, of course, the great Cicely Tyson, you know, she's gone, and a few other people that we've lost, you know, this year. So, yeah. As I said at the end of each video, know that I love you. If video and radio show, know that I love you for real. And always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and to love God, love yourself, and love other people beyond words. I love you all for real. I know that. Our radio family, I will see you all back here on March the 22nd. But podcast platforms are still going to continue to be rolling on. So follow me on all major social media platforms, major podcast platforms at the RH3 show. That's for social media tags. And just search the RH3 show on all major podcast platforms. Tune in, Google Podcasts, Apple iTunes, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Spreaker, all of them great places. Just search the RH3 show. And radio family, I will see you all when we return back on March the 22nd. That is going to be my 1 year anniversary celebration week for the RH3 show on our flagship station in the Bahamas. And so things are still up in the air. So, you know, our tentative date is March the 22nd. Something may happen before then. Some may not happen before then. We just might continue to come on come on that exact date. And so if that date is still, you know, stuck and, you know, or whatever, hey, we'll return. And if we don't return, then hey, God is good. But we're still going to be looking up and just continue to thank God for the best. All right, I'm out of here, you all. I love you for real. And scheduled. We'll see you all March the 22nd. And all is well and all is good and all will be well and good. All right, I'll see you all March the 22nd. Look, I'm gonna come in here like I said, kick in the dough, and hey. We're going to have some great promotions to pull the folks back in. So, hey, join me March the 22nd right here at 1 p.m. on the flagship station and on the podcast platforms. I love you all for real, and I'll see you all next time. We're going to come in like a hurricane, and we're going to do it all in the name of our Father. Our Chief Executive Holy Spirit is going to be spearheading it all, and it's going to be good. It's going to be good. You don't want to miss it. See you all then. All right. I love you all, friend. I'll talk to you soon. Peace.
Oh,